Hey guys, it's Greg. How's it going? So about a year ago now, I said that the deep learning specialization is probably the best certificate that you could get on your portfolio and your LinkedIn, at least for the money. You know, of course, there's other options that are way more expensive and more time consuming, like a university degree, of course, in anything that's close to mathematics or computer science or even most engineering's. You know, they're probably going to be a lot more beneficial and credible than a course from Coursera. But if you don't want to go down that route either at all or again, so if you've already done a bachelor's degree or something similar and you really don't want to do that again, then the deep learning specialization is definitely an awesome course to add to your portfolio. But now I want to ask, you know, it's 2 weeks after we've seen the Andrew Ng machine learning specialization that just came out. And, you know, a lot of people have taken it, like that video that I posted on it. I actually made two videos on it, one way before it started and one on the day it came out. And both of those have a lot of views. And so clearly a lot of you guys are taking this course and hopefully enjoying it. If you are taking it or considering, you know, drop a comment down below and tell me your thoughts on that. Because the topic of today's video is honestly, like, is this course the best course you could take or the best certificate you could get on your LinkedIn right now? Again, for the money, there's other options, but disregarding the super expensive and time-consuming stuff, is the machine learning specialization by Andrew Ng the best certificate you could put on your LinkedIn right now? Now, there's definitely some fingers pointing to, yes, it is. Of course, Andrew Ng is ridiculously credible. Almost all of the people doing machine learning right now in the field have either taken or strongly heard of Andrew Ng's original course. And so this course now, his new specialization, it basically replaces that. It puts it in Python instead of MATLAB. You know, before MATLAB was a little more popular, Python has really, really grown in traction since he made that course. And and Python really is just the go-to language for machine learning. At times, you might want to use C++, and there's certainly some people that use it in R. But the vast, vast majority of people would agree that Python is the language for just, you know, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, all of that stuff. Python is the way to go. Okay, so obviously, since the Andrew Ng machine learning specialization does put that in Python, that immediately makes it a million times better. And since it's Andrew Ng in Python and great material, you know, even just if you kind of think about it being the same as the old course, but updated, you know, it's all phenomenal there with those simple changes. But what really points to yes, in my opinion, this is the best certificate to take, is that, you know, he put a really good amount of changes in here. And specifically, the stuff on, you know, tree models, so like XGBoost, he works up to XGBoost. I think it's just a phenomenal choice. And he didn't have to, you know, the first course definitely didn't go into that stuff in that way. And I really, really like his decision on this, because, you know, that is such a widely used model. In fact, I don't know the statistics on it, but you know, the vast majority of people, if I ask, like, in companies, like, what are you using for, you know, your models, most of the time it's, you know, linear regression or logistic regression. Those two are super common, always. But then the more complex stuff, if it's like really, really heavy into computer vision or natural language processing, of course, they're going to use deep learning. But for the vast amount of models that are done like in tabular data, like on database style information, that's going to be the gradient boosting models, which is XGBoost. At least XGBoost is probably the most up-to-date and well-heard-of implementation of that. I need to take a drink. I have like hot apple cider and like ginger in this, and it's just, oh, it makes it so good for the throat when I'm speaking. Okay, so yeah, honestly, Andrew Ng's new machine learning specialization here, there's a really, really strong argument for this being the best certificate now. And this is not, this video is not really me trying to say like, yes, this is absolutely the best possible certificate. But those are the reasons why it is a yes. Also because it goes further into the deep learning stuff even better than before. Definitely is not a replacement to the deep learning specialization. You still want to take the Andrew Ng machine learning specialization and then the deep learning specialization after that. And of course, if you're looking for a whole data science pathway, I have that in the description. And so you can take a look at that on my recommendations. But yeah, those are really the arguments for yes, is you got Andrew Ng, just his face on there is extremely credible. The Coursera platform, you know, really well known in data science. The material, you know, really good updates like Python, XGBoost, the neural network stuff is really great additions. And, you know, the material is awesome as always. Yeah, so that's really the yeses. Now, in terms of the no's, if we want to talk about why it's not the most credible, I'm really just going to compare it to the fact that for the same amount of for the same price, basically, before I suggested that the deep learning specialization is the best certificate. Now, I just really want to talk about like, is it actually better than the deep learning specialization? Like, if you really were just to pick one of these courses, do I think that the Andrew Ng one is better than the deep learning specialization now? And I have to say no. And I think they're both required. And I think you need to take, or you should take, the Andrew Ng machine learning course before the deep learning specialization still. And so you're gonna have to take both anyway, in my opinion, at least that's in my pathway. But you know, I still think that the deep learning specialization is better. And that's because, you know, in the field of data science, it's hard to not be kind of get stuck in the everybody knows the same stuff kind of thing. And a lot of people are going to stop at kind of the machine learning course, you know, basic machine learning fundamentals, get in practice, start building projects. But it's still the people that are going to take the deep learning specialization, learn about all those really sophisticated architectures, try to take it even further and go down that route and just get more and more specialized and useful and, you know, learn a lot of really important stuff. So I still think that the deep learning specialization is a better and at least a must-have certificate to have. Okay, so those are really my thoughts. You know, again, drop a comment down below if you agree or disagree with what I said. If you, you know, you're taking some of these courses, then let me know what you're thinking about them. And yeah, I have the data science pathway in the description, the, you know, Andrew Ng machine learning course and the deep learning specialization. At least, you know, I'll put the machine learning course at the top and I'll have the pathway under it, which will of course have the deep learning specialization in that as well, somewhere in the pathway. It's like step 6 or something like that. I don't remember. Yeah. Okay. Drop a comment down below. Subscribe to the channel if you're not already, because I have, subscribe to the channel. And yeah, have a great day, guys. I hope you're doing really well. And yeah, I really do hope you have a great day. Okay. Bye-bye.